This song is an absolute banger, but it is a cover, and no, Madcon also did not write this song. Mm. But this is my favorite version.
Put your loving hands out, baby.
Yeah.
Cause I'm begging.
Woo.
Yahoo!
I've heard this, but not this live version. I love how he uses a lot of vocal fry in here. Vocal fry is really confusing in the vocal world because there are two types of fry: a fry distortion or growl, and vocal fry. Vocal fry is fry. Growl is hey, hey. This sort of gruff, staticky sound. So you can hear how he's using more of that hey sound in his voice to give it that rocky edge. It's really natural for him, although I think it's a choice because he can have clean singing in there. I want to tell you a little bit of the history of this song because it's really fascinating, but also let's go back and break down some of these little moments at the start. And excuse me stopping and starting because he does so many cool things. Really fast vibrato. In fact, I think it's more of a tremolo, and a tremolo is a variation in volume rather than just pitch, and it gives it this kind of fluttery sound.
But you're loving,
yeah,
hands out, baby,
baby. It's like an I love this really strong letting that air build up behind. He's really throwing around that riff instead of he's not making it really placed and precise. He's allowing it to be a little bit wobbly, a little bit imprecise, and that makes it feel a little bit more rock and roll-y. Okay, and he's gonna sing on begging on the NG sound, which is really unusual and adds his nasality. And then he literally starts the U as a yeah, as a scream yeah, before narrowing into an oo sound and letting it land on the pitch, which gives it this like, whoa, he's just making this expression, and then he kind of catches it and brings it back to a musical place. It's really, really interesting.
Woo!
And he's on the note on woo! So I'll often use woo! Get people to make that noise in order to find their head voice. If you can woo it, you can sing that note too. I love these. Begging you. And then adding this little as on the end as a little kind of funky percussive note.
Oh, baby, I'm begging you. So put your loving hands out.
I love how you can hear his Italian accent a little bit.
When I was king, I played it.
Okay. Allowing that to flip up to his head voice there. Okay. Is something that adds that freedom to it. Makes it feel really playful and fun. And I think that's part of like the allure of this band. They're so playful and fun. Now this song was originally sung by Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Who knew? And the songwriter was Bob Gaudio. I never know how to say his name. Gaudio. Let me know in the comments. Now, in spite of this band being a very popular band and the song being an absolute banger, for some reason it only got to number 16 in the charts with the Four Seasons. And I do like that version, although it's a little bit less raucous. Then there was the Madcon version, which is the version which I first heard, and that had a kind of coolness to it.
Ooh,
this again has thrown it apart and made it super rocky. It wasn't also initially a hit for Måneskin. It wasn't until 2021, when they won the Eurovision Song Contest, that people went back to their back catalogue and were like, oh my goodness, this is really cool. So I have no idea why this song continues to not be an instant hit, but it's an instant hit with me.
We just want to say to the whole Europe, to the whole world, rock and roll never dies! You want me dead, but easy come and easy go. And everyone and so 18 months, see you let me know.
Y'all
18 months, will you let me go? 18 months, see you got me no. But I plan, I just see you just let me go. Because I'm on my knees and I'm begging. Because I don't want to lose you.
Is that the Malcolm version? I can't remember.
Hey, yeah. Da, 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 da.
Woo! I love the rolled R as well, which is an Italian rolled R, which comes from the tongue hooking up like this and the air blowing over the end of the tongue and the end of the tongue vibrating, making the rolly R. I'm terrible at it. So there is a rap in the Madcon version, but I don't think there is in the Four Seasons version. Makes sense because of the era. But what lifts this a little bit more, in my opinion, is the tempo. It's a little bit faster, which gives it that rocky energy. Of course, you've got that really funky bass line going on underneath, and the rocky guitars and drums really lifts it and makes it an energetic performance. It makes the rap feel all the more impressive because it's so fast.
I'm trying hard to hold on, just gonna make it all alone. I'm holding on.
They, as a band, are amazing performers. Obviously, the lead singer, I think is Damiano is his name, often gets a lot of the attention because of his amazing stage presence, his very distinctive gritty tone and voice. But they are all rocking out, every single one of them. Every single one of them has a huge stage presence and really sings through their instruments.
I'm holding on and I can't pull back. Only then can I begin all over again. An empty shell I used to be. The shadows of my life was hanging over me. I broke
the mind. Is it me who's doing that?
But I don't know. When evil sand, the devil's dancing with my soul. What we chewing, what we chasing. Why the bottom, why the basement? Why we got you stuck and embrace it? Why the feel for the need to replace it? You're the wrong way, Jack in the cat. I wanna be the beach and tell where we could be at. Like a heart in the best way, shit. You can give it away, you too can. It's hard to pay, but I keep walking on, keep walking up, keep walking on. That the call is
yours,
keep
walking on.
Cause I don't wanna leave in a broken yogurt, I'm begging. Yeah.
So you can hear on his rap there, it's really, really clean. It's not as if his speaking voice is raspy or anything. So that raspiness is definitely a choice throughout. Probably become so natural that he doesn't even think about it that much anymore. It sounds really freaking cool. Now, what's also interesting is that his breath support is amazing. And because of that grittiness, that fry vocals, he has to be even more on top of his breath support and his energetic performance. And breath support is not more breath, it's managing the breath in a really efficient and effective way. So he's taking a lovely relaxed breath in and he is able to sustain a really, really long breath out.
Man, what we got, you stop and embrace it. Why the feel for the need to replace it? You're the wrong way, Jack in the cat. I wanna bring a beat to tell where we could be at. Like a
heart, so good.
We should. You can give it away, you too can. It's hard to pay, but I'll keep walking on, keep walking up, keep walking on. That the call is your people so hard. Cause I don't wanna leave in a broken yogurt, I'm begging.
I can hear his breath as well. He's really taking a deep breath. It's not like a short, sharp breath that is in the top of his body. I can hear the depth of the sound that he is creating, which means that air is going right down to the bottom of his lungs. Now, the thing about singing is that we do have to take short breaths, but we need to fill up our lungs enough to sustain the out breath. If we just go and then we don't have much breath, then we can't keep on going. So it's really important to understand where that movement is coming from, and that is your ribs and your diaphragm rather than your shoulders and your neck, which are going to limit the intake of breath rather than help that intake of breath. Like a heart in a bad way, shit. You can give it away, you too can. It's hard to pay, but I'll keep walking on, keep walking on, keep walking on. That the call is y'all, keep also home. Cause I don't wanna leave in a broken yoga, I'm begging. Yeah, yeah, cause I'm begging, begging you. I can stop put you now, my hands out, baby. Yeah, begging, love that slide as well. Begging you, I can stop put you now, my hands out, darling. I'm fighting hard to hold my own. Just can't make it all alone. I'm holding on and I can't fall back. You can really hear his breath now. He's really working. So there, when you get and you're hearing a little bit of tone, it's not your most ideal, because what is happening is his vocal cords are getting in the way as he's breathing in, and I think it's as he's getting towards the end of this song and he's getting a little bit more tired, his vocal cords don't have time to move out the way, so you're hearing the sound of his vocal cords and the air rushing past them backwards. Ideally, it should be fairly silent is the most efficient way. Of course, he's still singing fantastically, and these things are bound to happen within a performance like this. This is at the American Music Awards. There's a lot of energy going around. You're never going to take the most 100% perfect breath every single time. In fact, every breath you take is a little bit different. It's just something to be aware of in your own singing. And the other side of it is to give yourself a break when you don't do 100% the most perfect breath ever. I see students come into lessons and be like, this wasn't perfect. And I'm like, still sounded wicked. Who cares? That's part of being human, right? I'm fighting hard to hold my own. He's communicating, and that's what's important. I'm holding on and I can't fall back. I'm just a calm that I'm fading. Cause I'm begging, begging you. I love this breakdown, it's so good. I'm begging, begging you. To put your loving hands up, darling. That was pretty long. I think it's like 13. So it shows even there that even with a tiny little inefficiency in his breath, he's still able to maintain that super long note at the end with distortion and grit as well, which is really, really difficult. His out-breath is fantastic. And after a couple of slightly less efficient breaths, he gets his breathing back in check. And sometimes those little top-up breaths can be really helpful in maintaining the breath as well. And you know what? Here we are, microanalyzing breaths. But what's really important is that this song is full of energy. It makes you feel something. I don't know about you, but I did. Before you go, I have just released my very own album, Fable. Some of the songs are available here on YouTube and some are available on Spotify, but the whole album is on my website, bethroars.com, and I'd love if you could go and check it out. All right, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.